International Day commemorating the victims of acts of violence based on religion or belief is observed every August 22nd. Across the globe, millions have been victims of violence and death due to their religious beliefs and ideologies. The Roman Catholic Church in St. Lucia is no exception. On May 8, 1977, Sister Frances Teresa Keenan was murdered during a Mother's Day Mass in Graceview Fort. In 1980, Bishop Lester Gully was kidnapped in Castries. The most famous and tragic is the 2000 New Year's Eve attack on the Minor Basilica of the Immaculate Conception. Perpetrators stormed the church wielding machetes and setting the place ablaze. Sister Teresa Egan, who had served as an educator for many years, and Father Charles Guyard died from injuries received in the attack. Several others were left with injuries such as burns and trauma. Father Michele Francis, Vicar General of the Archdiocese of Castries, says that there are other places in the world where Christians have been attacked by extremists in other religions. On Ireland, he says there are over 200 recorded religions. However, he describes the diversity as beautiful. If there is one lesson to be learned from these attacks, Father Michele says it is tolerance and respect for one another.
At the end of the day, I think we can coexist. And there is no need to disrespect somebody's faith in the same way that we politically, we have two major political parties. And if we had five, you would have had persons who would be members of all of the they would choose one of the five. And not because we do not have the same persuasion politically, that we should disrespect people.
Similar incidents would occur in the years to come. On April 12, 2006, Cardinal Kelvin Felix was attacked and grabbed by the neck by a man with a knife after he finished an evening sermon at the Basilica of the Immaculate Conception in Castries. In July of 2020, a young man threw two homemade Molotov cocktails at the crucifix of St. Martin de Porres Catholic Church in Peru, Vieux-Fort. On Sunday, May 8, 2022, another incident took place at the Our Lady of the Assumption Church in Vieux-Fort. A man exploded two Molotov cocktails inside the building. Father Michele says that it is not uncommon for Christians to suffer due to their beliefs. He says Catholics have been persecuted and killed since the resurrection of Christ. Yet still, he says much progress has been made world over.
And we worship the same God. Just that we call different names. Some call him Allah, some call Jehovah, some the Jews Yahweh, and the Jews don't even mention that name Yahweh because that name is so sacred. We say God. So why should we fight over God and not fight for him? Yeah, that's what we should be doing. So my earnest prayer is that as we develop and as we become a global village, that we will come to recognize that religion, our belief, our faith should not divide us, separate us to the point where we can become hostile to one another.
As part of the island's venture into religious tourism, a shrine will be erected in memory of the deadly New Year's Eve attack on worshippers at the Minor Basilica of the Immaculate Conception.
It will be a place to be visited and also to offer the opportunity for people who want to pray. So when visitors come, when locals come, when people from our region come, and churches like the cathedral are always, places of attraction. And everywhere you go in the world, those churches, whether they be synagogues or mosques or Christian churches, they form part of the historic visit that people will pay. Some people, they love to go to cemeteries and to read the epitaphs, the headstones, so that they could get the history. So that will serve as a kind of a history of what had happened, and hopefully it's not going to happen again.
Father Michele says that people have a right to make different choices and have their own beliefs. Whilst we may not necessarily agree with these choices and beliefs, he says they must be respected. For the DBS News World, Miriam Montout reporting.